So here's a super advanced tutorial that involves programming. So say you had a presentation you wanted to create and the data for the presentation was in a spreadsheet. So here I have a numbers document with one sheet and one table in it. So as simple as can be, numbers document. And it's got a list here of all the states and the state flower. And I've also had a scientific name, but I'm not going to use that here. So I want to create a presentation that has one slide each for the state and its flower. So I have 50 slides in the presentation. Could be used for various different things. Doesn't necessarily have to be this topic, but you get the idea. And this could be a lot longer text, whatever. I don't want to have to create 50 different slides and copy and paste all this data across. So how can I do it using programming? Well, I can using the script editor, which is an app that comes with your Mac, and some JavaScript programming. Now, script editor in the past has been used for AppleScript, and you could switch between AppleScript and JavaScript. JavaScript is much more modern, advanced programming language. A lot more people know, and I use it for lots of things. So I try to stick with JavaScript when I can, and it turns out it's a lot easier to do this task in JavaScript. So I wrote this very short little script here that will do exactly this, and let me go through it with you. So the first two lines are basically just going to declare the term numbers with a capital N as the application numbers and keynote with a capital K as the application keynote. Just shortens the typing for the rest here. Then I'm going to create something called table. And table is going to point to, in numbers, the first document, the first sheet, and the first table. Notice these zeros in here. JavaScript is a zero-based array language, so zero is first, one is second, two is third. So, first document, first sheet, first table. In other words, this table right here. Now, presentation is going to be the first document in Keynote, which is this one. I only have one document open at each one here, so it avoids confusion. Then I'm going to create a variable called SlideMaster, and that's going to point to presentation.masterSlides, something called title and subtitle. Where does this come from? Well, if I go to View Edit Master Slides in Keynote, you can see here are all the master slides, and the first one's called Title ampersand Subtitle. So I'm using exactly the name of that slide in the master slide there to basically give it this variable here. So as I create new slides, I'm going to create them using this slide template right there. So you could have chosen one of the other ones, and you can certainly go ahead and edit the title and subtitle one as well to customize it to fit what you need before you run this. Alright, so here we go. So this is where it's handy to do JavaScript because you can do just normal for loops here, which if you've ever done JavaScript programming, it's pretty standard. It's going to loop starting at 1 through to the number of rows. So table.rowCount, the number of rows in the table. And I++ means it's going to increase, go from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, etc. until it gets to the end of the table. Now, I said before it was 0 based here, so shouldn't I be starting at 0? Well, there's a header row here. It says state, comma name, scientific name. So I don't want to include that one, so I'm starting at 1. I'm starting at the second row there. Okay, so I'm going to create a new slide that's keynote.slide, and I'm feeding it the information that base slide is going to be slide master, which is this up here. So in other words, it's going to create a new slide based on this slide master template. Then I'm going to do presentation.slides.push new slide. So I'm going to add the new slide. Then I'm going to set something called the default title item of that slide to the table.rows I, so row 2 will be the first one here. Cell 0, so the first column, and its value. And default body item instead of default title item to the same thing except cell 1 instead of cell 0. In other words, the second column there. So default title item and default body item are these fixed things inside of Keynote that JavaScript knows to look for. So nothing I created. They're just for all those slides there. They either have a default title item or a default title item and default body item. So that's just something that's just part of how Keynote works and how it's hardwired with these two special things. So it's going to loop through there, create a new slide, and populate it with each one. So let's try it. I'm going to run it and we'll watch here and we'll see the slides appear. And there they all are. Goes to 51 because I have that first slide here that was blank that was already sitting there. And you can see Alabama, Alaska, etc. And just to give you an example of another way this could be useful, I'm going to select them all here and delete them and do it again, except I'm going to copy and paste. Increase the font size again for you so you can see it. So I'm going to copy and paste. So basically I'm going to do this twice. I'm going to create a slide and put the state name and the flower. Create a slide, put the state name and flower. But for the first one, I'm going to remove the flower. So it's only going to create a slide putting the state name there and then another slide with the state name and flower. What happens when I do that? Well, I'm going to get 100 slides instead of 50. And the first one is just going to be the name of the state and this one is going to be empty. And the name of the state and then the flower. So when I play the presentation, it's kind of like a quiz. You can ask your class, if it's school, what's the state flower of Alabama, or what's the state capital of Alabama, or anything, and the next slide has the answer. Alaska, and the next slide has the answer. So that's the basics of how to do it. You can imagine where you can go from here. You can randomize these here and have a random order to them. You can include more text here for more detailed stuff. You can basically create a nice template here that has a beautiful slide in it and then populate it with different things for different presentations or with new numbers. So say if you have run an organization, there's like 30 different things with 30 different statistical numbers to them and you want to redo this every month, you can populate it using this and those 30 different numbers go to the 30 different slides very easily. So lots of cool stuff you can do and the basics here are just this, just learning how to program some JavaScript to take information from numbers and put it into Keynote.